welcome back to Mimi Miller TV. Today, I have a special guest, and I'm so excited. We are going to be talking about the holistic secrets of entrepreneurial success. Yes, alkalizing foods, energetic foods, things that help us to live a more fuller and longer life. Amrit Daswani is an LA-based fitness professional and creator of resistance-based yoga flow called Daswani Method. This 30-minute sequence consists of 16 key movements inspired by traditional Hatha yoga, functional training, and Chinese medicine. No equipment is necessary, and this routine can be done anywhere, anytime. I mean, it's really designed to reboot your physiology and calibrate the energetic body. Resistance-based yoga flow will, you know, increase strength and flexibility, improve my posture and your posture, alignment and joint mobility, promote fat loss, increase blood flow and oxygen flow, prevent injuries, reduce stress and emotional trauma. Now, he's originally from Mumbai, India. Amrit began training in yoga at the age of 13 after his father passed away of diabetes. And at the time, he was a popular DJ in Mumbai nightlife. But after seeing his father struggle with alcoholism, he knew he was destined to follow a different path, one of health, wholeness, and compassion. At the age of 20, Amrit broke his back and tore his rotator cuff, lifting weights with poor form, and he was able to heal his injuries through alignment-based training. His yoga and meditation practice allowed him to keep a positive attitude during this time and create a space of healing. So through his experience, Amrit realized that his life's purpose was to empower and teach others how to live a more healthy, pain-free, and optimal life. He has healed clients of sciatica, hip pain, shoulder pain, and other injuries like working on my knee right now. Welcome, Amrit Daswani. Thank you for being here. Saying this is all about the secrets of entrepreneurial success. And because I've been a 20-year professional, I really, it's been very important for me to eat electrifying foods or alkalizing foods. I know the new buzzword today is electrifying, and it's always been about, you know, just decreasing the acidic environment in my body, as well as, you know, keeping down the inflammation, because I used to be a very heavy woman. I used to eat cheese and a lot of bad things, and I noticed that as I changed my diet, my mental capacities increased, my, you know, overall health. I was able to think and have the stamina and business that you need as an entrepreneur. So tell us about what inflammation is and why is it so important that we even understand about inflammation and anti-inflammation.
Definitely. Hi guys. So I'll just start off by talking a little bit about the stomach health and how it's actually the second brain. And whatever you put in your stomach is going to be a reflection of your thought patterns. And especially as entrepreneurs, it helps to have a clear mindset and a clear mind frame to operate out of, so that you can perform your task with ease. Start off by saying the thread linking a wide variety of common problems, health problems from obesity and diabetes like my father had, to heart diseases, to cancer, is one thing. That one thing is chronic inflammation. Most people have it, they don't even know it, that the thoughts are kind of all over the place. But when you change that, it changes the way you think, the way you interact with your environment. And the key to reducing the chronic inflammation starts with your diet.
Inflammation drives down the levels of serotonin, which can lead to feelings of depression or anxiety, and problems with mental fatigue. And you really need your mind space, your full mind capacity when making business deals every day, business decisions, understanding clients and things like that. And it really prevents melatonin from being produced in your body, which causes insomnia.
instead of the diet being a limitation of drawing you down from your true potential. Some of the things I'd like to share with you guys is anti-inflammation foods and stuff you guys can eat, or your viewers can eat, and stuff that we've been eating will help. So being liberal with the use of high quality herbs that we've been using, spices, herbs and spices.
Yes.
These are the simplest ways to boost the anti-inflammatory qualities in food. And I'm going to talk about four of them today.
Ginger helps to relieve my digestive system and help things flow. And it's also helped me from being sick. I remember when I first moved here, and you'd think California, nobody would ever get sick with colds and things like that.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
When I moved here, there was this tea shop that was down, the specialty tea shop that was below us. And so I would go get this strong ginger tea they had. And I noticed that everyone in my job got sick every single week. And I don't even know if they were conscious of that. I used to ask them, I'm like, how are you guys sick? Like, everybody was sick every other week.
Yeah, so I mean, a great way to start your day off would be ginger tea with a little bit of lemon. Amazing. It's gonna alkalize your body, increase the pH levels in your blood, making you way more energetic, and it's gonna destroy any kind of fungus or bacteria that you have, because ginger has a lot of. So turmeric, as you know, we use it a lot in Indian cooking, and there's a chemical called curcumin in turmeric, and curcumin exhibits over 150 therapeutic properties, including anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial activity, and anti-cancer properties. A lot of people have cancer cells and they don't even know it.
Wow.
Because their body is in such an acidic state, and then they wait till the last moment until, you know, they actually get cancer, and then they freak out, and then, you know.
And then they're on turmeric juice and going vegan.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. So it's better to do it now.
Preventative.
Right.
Yeah.
And so, as you can see, the texture and the color in turmeric is yellow, and it's often used in Indian cuisine, but the spice is far more than a cooking staple. It also has a long history of medicinal uses in traditional Chinese medicine as well as Ayurveda. So traditional medicine uses the turmeric for treatment of liver disease, for skin problems, for respiratory problems, for gastrointestinal ailments, for sprained muscles. It helps with recovery, it helps with joint pain, and it's also good for wound healing.
Wow, that's awesome. Yes, that's awesome. And you need your limbs to be able to function. You know, I mean, we have so much, we have to, generally in entrepreneurship, we don't have 9-to-5s. We have maybe a 9-to-5 one day, a 10-to-7 the next day, a 12 to 2 a.m. in the morning. You know, our hours are flexible. We have to keep the inflammation and stress levels down in order to, you know, be flexible. And thank you for all those things. And
yeah,
join us
definitely.
For part two of Holistic Secrets to Entrepreneurial Success. It's going to get deeper. So like, subscribe, and you can see his recipes that we'll be showing on here. I will see you in a second. You're right. Amrit
Daswani.
And I like your hair now. You're looking good. There we go. You get it together real quick. Yes, yes. Did you put some gel on it or something? This looks good.
Yeah. Okay.
No, you ain't putting no gel on it. Sorry, I'm just getting it together. Look at me so squirmish. Damn.
Am I fine now?
Uh-huh.